Chris Arsenal thing? Is that what is his status?
Yeah, I don't get into injuries and personnel. So if you want to talk about that, talk to the head coach about injuries and personnel.
How did you think Rennie did with his first extended look as the main?
I thought he did really good. I think Rennie ran the ball very strong. There's a couple runs, obviously, he'd like to have back. What Rennie did excellent was just pass protection. He was great in pass protection. Our offensive line was very good in pass protection. They brought a ton of blitzes, ton of fire zones, and our guys did a great job picking up their disruptive looks and understanding the rules and communicating. Thought he played real well.
What did the film show you about Mason's performance?
Oh, well, obviously there were some inconsistent throws, but he battled back. He battled through. He was able to bounce back and be resilient at the end. There's just simple things, very correctable mistakes. A high throw here, just not setting his feet and setting his hips where he need to be, getting his eyes in the right direction. But get that corrected this week and move forward, look at the things we did wrong and get those things corrected.
Is that, poor throws, whether it's footwork or release point, is that easier to correct than, it seemed his decision-making was fine because, Jarwin was open on that one throw. Would you rather have it be a sort of mechanical issue than decision-making issue?
I think so. I think that's fair because at least the mental part of it's right and he's making the right decisions. So, yes, I would agree with that.
Early in the season, we talked about the Walsh package, and I thought it was cool that he had a lot of influence in it. But I think a lot of the outside expectations, people didn't think it would be this successful. I mean, that's like a vital part of this red zone offense. How nice is it to see JW, a guy who could have left and started somewhere else, to have so much success in this package so far?
It's great. He's a team guy.
Yeah.
He means so much to this program and what he's given. It's great to see him, have the productivity and get rewarded on the field, obviously. But we'll continue to build on that package. It's a big part of what we do, and obviously it provides wrinkles and it's situational, which is good. So it brings us another element, as everybody knows. But it's just great to see a leader like that, a guy that's given everything to the program, get back on game day and get in the end zone and have some big plays at critical times. That's the thing, it's good to have that wrinkle, but it's also great to have a dependable guy in those really critical situations.
Does anyone get more excited about a touchdown than him? He's that guy who sprints to his receivers and he's got these huge fist pumps. I mean, yeah. it's fun to watch.
It's great. Our guys understand celebrating together, and it's great to see them enjoy themselves and have fun.
Mason said it was kind of a throwback having you on the sidelines to his high school days. Did you like that face-to-face? I mean, yeah. I know there's advantages of being in the box, but
yeah,
to be down there, I mean, was that fun? Was that a cool part of the day?
Oh, yeah, it was fun, and it was a lot more emotional.
Yeah.
You're not as cerebral when you're up in the box. You feel kind of like a caged animal, But, it was great interacting and getting eye contact with the players and with the coaches as well. A little hectic because we couldn't communicate real well.
Yeah.
It was a loud environment, but we overcame that and it was out of our control. I think we did the best we could with that situation. But definitely fun and a lot more emotion on the sideline.
Well, I was going to say, were you then in the scrum of celebration when Grogan's field goal goes through? Were you kind of in with the guys maybe in ways
I didn't get too excited. I mean, obviously my heart was pounding pretty good, but you just try to stay in the moment, make sure guys weren't running on the field and that sort of thing.
We talk about Mason's game and some of the struggles he had, and you can break down the film and all that, but I think people outside the program forget this is his seventh start, and he's just a young guy in a raucous environment. I mean, is it as simple as that for some of the mistakes, him getting overhyped, him being, learning the flow of the game and everything slowing down, or do you think maybe he's past that at this point?
I think he's past that. I think we need to focus on the here and now.
Yeah.
And we need to look at which ways we can improve and what we have to do to go about that. And that's more film study. It's consistent play and practice and just work to get better every day. And that's all you really can do. There's no other way other than to just work and play, stay confident. There's no reason he shouldn't have a lot of confidence. He's a good player. He's a very good player. And we have a lot of confidence in him and so do his teammates. So, whether off day or not, we need to get back on the horse.
Yeah.
And have tremendous confidence in ourselves and tremendous confidence in him.